Dun, 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 dun.
Good morning and welcome to, I forget now.
Kernowec Lwenda.
Kernowec Lwenda.
The Copper Coast Cornish Festival.
Yay!
Kernowec Lwenda.
Yeah, it's a bit weird. Oh, look at that Chev
Oh.
there, 55. That's really
Where's the
nice.
car parade tomorrow?
Oh yeah, that's gonna be mad. So yeah, we're at Kadena and it's spread, this festival's spread out like over three towns. We'll check out the Chev. So yeah. They're having like some big street festival thing here, and oh, they're wrapping the ribbon around the pole. How cool!
So that must be a Cornish thing.
I've seen so many like old photos of them doing this in like Queensland and stuff, but I've never
dress
actually
the
seen it
part
happen.
too.
Oh, this should be pretty cool. Let's go have a look. Ooh, ring around the rosy. Wow, must have been pretty boring back in Cornwall if this was the most exciting thing to do.
You came up with this, yeah.
Yeah, there are still some places.
Headwear though, it's cute, eh?
Yeah, it's all a bit different, eh? I don't get what the idea of it is. Is it supposed to make pretty patterns on the pole or what? You
feel
know.
Like, I feel like they're unwinding it now.
Yeah, they wind it up and then they unwind it. It's weird.
So are they decorating or undecorating the pole?
Yeah. Bit of both. Street here, there's another maypole and there's some people like all dressed up really flash, eh? Look at that. Oh, it's like the Stone Ages or the Dark Ages. Some ages anyway. Mate here, he's on his traditional Cornwall mobile phone.
Very in keeping.
Keeping in character. So we found out on Google that like Cornish people, they're either come from or they're associated with Cornwall, and that they're their own ethnic minority in Britain, which is pretty weird, eh? Apparently, like when they were the people that were there before the Romans come, and they stayed isolated from the Romans, so they're more inbred because they didn't interbreed with them as much. And yeah, that's why they're their own people. It's pretty
yeah,
weird. I had no idea there was like different like white people,
different, like Anglo kind of
ethnic groups in Britain. But there you go.
There you go.
Man, so down here there's more maypole dance and stuff, and over here they have like the traditional Cornish markets. Cornish people must have invented like markets, hey? So we'll have a quick look through there too, because the maypole stuff's like not the most exciting for the most part. They're just standing there like this. Oh, come in one of the old buildings, and not like that. But now we're gonna have a look. They've got like an art gallery going in here. So this looks pretty cool. The old bloke stopped me. He's like, oh, no photographs in here. And then he's like, it's $4 each entry. I'm like, oh, yeah, okay, see ya.
Yeah. You can see most of it just peering
from
over
the door.
His shoulder. Yeah,
yeah.
So.
Yeah. Oh, well, bad luck. And look, traditional Cornwall dogs. How mad's that? Oh, look. Woolworths is Cornish as well, eh? They started off selling in the Cornish markets.
Origin story.
More dogs, hey? How cool are the dogs? Gotta love dogs. It's pretty trippy. We just ran into the lady from the hardware shop at Port Pirie, eh? She's here selling like 3D printed dragons she's been making and stuff. Hey, that was really cool. So if we need anything 3D printed, I know who to go ask now.
Sarah at Butterton.
Oh look, the Cornish caravan weighing dudes here. I'd love to get our van weighed just so I know what it weighs.
We're definitely
underweight.
Yeah,
because we like ditched heaps of stuff and stripped stuff out, and no microwave anymore and things like that. And so
we'd definitely be under. But
yeah, easy.
Nice to be.
But it'd be nice to know. So one day maybe.
Just pat ourselves on the back.
But yeah, if you've got a caravan, like definitely come and get this done, because I'm sick of driving at 60Ks in 100K zones behind you. Signs everywhere saying that there's like
Cornish swanky.
Swanky. So we don't know what swanky is. But oh man, I might have found
one
actually. Check this out. Whoa! Oh man, very I wish swanky. We'd dressed up. Yeah. Swanky as. The old Cornish basketball cards, eh? All these Michael Jordan ones, they're mad. And over there's Pokemon stuff. Oh, Mockle dogs, what is he? He's a story dog. So he reads books and stuff, eh? It's pretty cool. Yeah, so they were reading dogs, eh? They don't like actually read, but they take them around the schools and they all sit in a big group with hugging the dog while they're reading books and things. Mm. So yeah, that's pretty
cool.
They're
like a captive audience for the kids reading, and, which is awesome.
He said he'd done some work with like aged care people and kids with
autism
and stuff as well with them. So yeah, that's really cool.
How they get the dogs to like lie on, a kid with autism to calm him down, but then they end up sort of bonding over the whole experience. It's just, beautiful home.
Yeah, I'd love to get a service dog like that, take it around aged care places, it'd be mad.
Yeah.
One day maybe.
We talked about doing it with Jetta, yeah.
Let's go see what the Cornish trucks are. So it's the sideshow bit. Hide your money.
Traditional Cornish sideshow.
It's easy to find. Show time is flat time.
No, it's not. Right, so we found that swanky thing. What is it? It's a drink. Yeah, it's a drink.
It's an ale.
$8 a can, it'd want to be some drink. Yeah, give that one a miss too. Oh, more dogs, eh? Dogs everywhere today. And there's another dog over there. He doesn't look very Cornish, that dog. Dogs of the corn. Oh, they're selling traditional Cornish pasties here. Haven't seen one yet, so I don't know what they look like or what, but that's where they sell them. And then over here they have a big train in the park. Now I don't think the train's got anything to do with corn, but it's just in the park, so we'll have a look. Should have got on the Jonathan Davies and got corn to come and play, eh? Then that would have been the most Cornish thing here. All right. We're on the train. Oh look, it's even got a drink holder. That's mad. What does it all do? Toot toot.
Nothing for a while.
I think this is the seat, eh? You never see seats on the other trains we've seen, eh?
Apparently energy drinks are very...
Oh yeah.
It's a popular spot.
We're in the right place then. Yeah, the train's pretty cool. It's not the most exciting, but... You just don't see many steam trains anymore anywhere. So yeah, it's mad. And how Cornish is the weather as well? It's
yeah, it feels like it.
It's getting colder and colder. And it's been a bit drizzly today. And yeah, it's probably the wettest day that we had in South Australia so far, actually.
So I guess it rings true to Cornwall, probably.
Yeah, I guess that's why they all moved here, so they could all freeze in winter. Reminds me of home. Here comes the traditional Cornish street dancing.
It's like a jaunty march.
Oh, here we go. Do some spins and stuff. All the children of the corn. Wow, that lady did a good job dressing up, eh? She's got the big bum thing going on and all the frills, and the umbrella.
I love the umbrella.
Yeah. She's done a mad job. Are you ready? Loving it. It's just like being back home, freezing me ass off. Children of the corn, I'm the firstborn. I'm How old school is that? They got a Retrovision, eh? Remember the old ads? And it was like, Retrovision, the biggest retailer of electrical appliances. And then they have like some lady in there with like a massive stereo. And it's like, no, no, not the retailer of the biggest electrical appliances. Well, tomorrow should be good, eh? There's like some Festival of Cars thing on.
Oh, yeah.
And just like the cars parked in the street here are awesome. So if these are some of the cars that we're going to see.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah. Whoa, look at this. Oh, what a beast. And the soft top roof. It's like a big coupe wagon. Yeah, wow. Oh, that's sick. I have no idea what it is, eh? Oh, look at the steering wheel on it.
Wow.
Wow. What a monster. Man.
Wow, how nice is the interior? Wow.
Yeah. Oh, it's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. What does the wheel say? Undo. Doesn't tell you who made it. Yeah, oh, it's sick. Wow, so check it out, eh? It's a Jaguar. It's an SS Jaguar. Like, is this one the Germans were using? Doubt it, because Jaguars are like pommy cars, eh?
Looks like something you'd see Hitler in.
Yeah, oh yeah. It. Wow, man, it's so cool. And then, oh, check out across the road. There's the old Statesman, and man, that thing is mint. Wow. There's the old Padge beside it there, eh? Everyone likes a nice Pajero. Out this thing. Oh, man. How would you like a life-size Larry?
You be careful, you might spit at you.
Yeah. Yeah. People around here are like that. I think she was talking about a husband.
Or Larry the Llama.
Oh, Larry. Oh, okay, maybe. It's funnier to think that she was talking about a husband, though. But yeah, it says take a selfie with him. Don't climb on him, though. Damn. Well, I'm not real keen on a selfie if I can't sit on you, mate. Check out the Morris. Oh, man, it's sweet. Oh, the interior's really nice in there, too, eh? Oh, and they've got like blankets like our blankets. Oh, yeah. Ah, she's an early one as well with the low lights. So I must be a 50. These are like ugly as, but they're more sought after. I wouldn't own one though. I like the ones with the headlights in the top of the guard. But yeah, it's pretty cool, I guess. Ah, sick old EHA. I miss my old man had one, eh? Used to love driving it around. I actually, hit a kangaroo in it. The only car I ever hit a kangaroo in was an EH. And the kangaroo didn't come off real great, but we just straightened out a little bit of the grill on the car and realigned the bonnet, and the car was mint. So yeah, you can't beat old cars, eh?
Tough.
Yep. Oh wow, check out this one. Type 3 notchback. Like a Beetle with a different body on it, pretty much. But oh man, you don't see many Type 3s around anymore. Oh, it's automatic too, eh? I wonder if they're semi-autos like the Beetle. Oh, you can't tell because they've got the gear shifter covered up. Well, that's no fun. Oh yeah, love me a good old Volkswagen, eh? Man, like, who even needs to go to the car show tomorrow? Like, you can just walk around and have a look. Like, check this out.
I really like it.
Oh, what a beast.
I've never seen one in that color.
Beast. Yeah, I think that's like a standard color for them, eh?
Oh.
Like that might be original.
I thought they were all in the pea green.
And you can tell it's early one too, because it's got the lights in the bumper. So only the first lot of them had that. The rest of them have the lights above the bumper in the bodywork there. So yeah, she's a HQ. Yeah, wow. Oh man. It is really nice. It's not even the car I come to look at. Oh, wow. Oh, man, how cool is that paint? Get me a 120Y coupe in this paint would be awesome. Oh, and she's driven from New South Wales too, eh? That's a bit of a mission. Man. And over the back here, check out this. Oh, man, what a beast. I think it's a... Is it an old Cortina? I'm gonna have to go have a look. Oh yeah, check this out. Nice as. Oh, he's got the club lock. I used to have a club lock in me Datsun, but some lady run me off the road and I ended up throwing it at her and had to go to court.
I had one in my first car and, in the Proton Wirra.
It was no fun. Don't throw your club lock at people if they run you off the road. Yeah, wow, so it's the Capri, hey? It's probably got like the Cogsworth, 3-litre V6 in it. So, that's like a really rare car, eh? People would kill for that thing. Over here, there's a couple other cars. You got the Rover, and then that's a Volkswagen Karmann Ghia. Same, it's like another Volkswagen Beetle with a different body on it. And some old Pommy thing as well, eh? And then there's this sick old Mercedes. Oh wow, so they're all from New South Wales. Must be like the European car club or something, eh? The Rover, man, this is one of the nicest ones I've ever seen, eh? Look at the roof on it and stuff. Wow. Yeah, 3.5 litre alloy V8 in these things. Same as like in Land Rovers and stuff. It's mad. And the Karmann Ghia, man, oh, this thing is nice as. I've seen a few of these, but I don't know if I've ever seen one that was this good. And this thing here is a Morris Oxford. She's a bit of a boxy beast. It's nowhere near as nice as everything else we've looked at, though. Duck in the Woolies quickly and do our traditional Cornish shopping for the week. Oh, man. Sarah's just saying we should have got corn chips, but man, you just buy what's cheap these days, eh? Have you seen the price of chips lately?
Oh, wow, that's crazy.
What a ripoff. Oh, so I was just thinking, I reckon that Beavis and Butthead might be Cornish too. That's why he's like, I am Cornholio. I need PP for my bumhole. Oh man, the car park's been the best bit, eh? There's just so many old cars. Like, I couldn't even show you half of them if I tried today. Check this one out. Oh yeah, how nice is this? Looks like I think it's a 55 or a 56 Chevy. It's not a 57 anyway, it's a little bit earlier. You can tell because the fins get wilder until you get to 57. But oh man, what a car. It's so nice. Now check out this car. How mince is VS? Oh man, that's Mickey Az. But over here, oh, look at this one. Like, where do these people get these cars? No way. I don't know if that's original or what, eh? Like, I've never noticed GTS on the rear guard before like that. So, thinking it's just someone's bad mock-up. But you never know. Man, what a mad car, hey? VN wagon. Check it out. Mint. Well, it's not mint, but, oh, man, that'd do some sick burnouts.
It looks like a burnout car, yeah.
Was it when you could just go and buy a VN for $500, man? And now, like, people want crazy money for the stuff. Alright, go back and make some lunch now, and then we'll see what happens this afternoon. But yeah, the Cornish Festival place here at Kadena has been pretty cool. And there's still like two other towns where all this stuff's going on as well.
There's like a street party in Wallaroo, so
might
go check that out. So,
yeah, I think we're going to Wallaroo then. So we'll see you there probably. So welcome to Wallaroo. You can come too, but you have to drive here, so I'm picking you up. Oh man, so we don't know what's going on here. There's some other street party thing, but oh, I've just seen the sickest car here too, eh? Oh man, check it out. It's a Charger. Looks like it's the top of the range one too, with like the RT badges or whatever it is. Get out of the way. Yeah, wow. Beast. Is that EH again, eh? Oh man, it sounds mean too, eh? Oh wow. Here's old Chrysler wagon, eh? Almost in the same colour as the Charger. Yeah, that's mad. Oh yeah, and this EH is really nice too, eh? Alright, so turns out they're having like a street party, but we're too early. It doesn't start for like another hour or something, so we're just having a wander around. And then we'll come and I guess listen to some music and then go find the Wallaroo free camp. I think there's a free camp here.
There is.
So that's probably where we stay tonight. This Cornish music's heaps better than the last Cornish music. That at the last town, it was driving me nuts. Couldn't escape it.
Oh, yeah, well, at least the music sounds like it's going to go off.
Well, that's pretty good.
Right, so we've gone around the block, and you know where that puts us?
Whoa, right back in front of the Charger. Six-pack Hemi, hey? Oh, no way. Oh, and another.
Wow.
Oh, and here comes the Sandman U. Oh, wow. Man. How sick is that? Like, how sick is this, though? Oh, yeah, you can have your Mad Holdens. I'll take the Charger. Wow, 265, eh? Beast.
Oh, they pulled up behind the Wombat, eh? How mad's that? Best view we've had in ages.
Some more sick old cars, eh? Wow. There's so many getting around. This show tomorrow is going to be mad. Alright, so while we're waiting, we come down to the big dock they've got here. So we'll get to see if anybody's catching any squid or nothing. We did come down here in like one of our other videos, but it was like freezing crappy day. So yeah, it wasn't the best. But and it's high tide today, which has made it even cooler. Whoa, let's get out on the dock. See if there's anyone catching anything. Oh, Mr. Cormorant. Hey, he's really cool, eh?
Yeah.
He's really letting us. I've never been this close to one, eh?
Yeah.
That's it, flap. Hey, hey, do you want some food or something? He's looking at me like, what do you got? Hey, hey. You're like a cool penguin that can fly, yeah. Hey? Stuff them silly penguins. Can't even fly. Whoa, so we're on like the end of this little bit of the jetty, and you can see the big ship there. It's filling up with grain from over in all the silos over there. And we didn't see anybody catch anything, but there's some people over there. They've caught some crabs they had in a bucket. So yeah, not much exciting today, but yeah, it's pretty nice. All right. So let's go back up the town and listen to some Cornish music. And then we're gonna go and get water and find a free cam. Oh, down here is another 55 Chevy, eh? And oh man, this one's really nice. Two door. Oh yeah. If it was a 57, man, that thing would be so sick. It's got some fat tires on it too, eh? She must go all right. Yeah, it must have a big block in it. That's why it's got BB number plates.
What's big block?
Big block's like an engine that's like bigger than a 350 or a 351. And they call it a big block because it has like a bigger block than the other ones. Oh, we saw this. Oh, yeah. Oh, and this wagon. We saw that before, but I didn't get any good video of it. And there's another 50 Chevy 8. Oh man. Ah, oh, the cars. How sick are all the cars? Yeah, we found a poster for the car thing that's happening. See, that's tomorrow, 21st of May 2023. And oh, look at all the cars. There's heaps of them. And we've already seen some of them. We already seen that one. Yeah, oh, it's gonna be sick. All right. So we made it in. We had to pay $7 to get on the street this time, and now I'm going to listen to some music and then go find a camp and stuff. Yeah, this is the best Cornish music we heard all day.
Oh yeah.
Alright, so that was getting a bit cold and boring, so we come to get our water, and then we're going to go and find this free camp. Too much pressure here, it's making our thing overflow. That's about it for today. It's been nice to have a break from the Peary house. It was getting a bit much being there every day. But yeah, tomorrow, go see this car show. And should be mad. See if we can egg someone on to do a big burnout.